everyone. It's a great joy and a privilege to have you again joining with us to discuss from the Word of God. So I welcome you to this program and I hope that God will bless each and every one of us. So now, before we proceed, let us bow our heads and pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you. We thank you so much for giving us this time, this privilege that we can learn from your word. Speak to us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. So, last week we have talked about reputation, what it means. Let me remind you again of what it means. Reputation, it means an overall quality or the character as seen by people in general. Or in short, I will say, I can define reputation as what someone is known for. What someone is known for. It is either a name or a fame that a person carries. So, last week we have talked about how reputation that we can carry in our life matters and how it matters. We have talked about that none of our parents would like to give us children by the name of Judas. Judas Iscariot in the Bible, because the name Judas itself carries a reputation. It is a bad name. That means he is a person who betrays Jesus, who sold Jesus to the religious leaders so that they can crucify him and kill him. In that manner, that is why it is good to have a good reputation. It is better to have a good reputation. The Bible itself says that a good name has to be chosen over riches and ointments. And we have talked about there's only two reputations, and we can carry only one of them in our life. We cannot carry both. That is, the number one reputation is a good reputation or a good name, and the second reputation is a bad reputation and a bad name. So, we have talked about what can spoil a reputation. What are the things that can spoil our reputation? Then we have talked about three things that can spoil a reputation. Number one is an unwholesome talk. What we speak, our foolish talk, our meaningless talk, they can ruin our reputation. Ecclesiastes chapter 10 verse 1, it says that a little folly, little foolish talk, foolish acts, it outweighs wisdom and honor. It outweighs wisdom and honor. Not only that, our foolish talk, whatever we talk, we have to give an account before God. That is what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 12, verse 36. He says, "But I tell you that everyone will have to give an account on the day of judgment for every empty words. For every empty word they have spoken, you have to give an account before God." That is why it is very good. It is better for us to have this in mind, that we should control our tongue. Which leads to the second point. The second point that we have looked of on the things that can ruin our reputation is if we cannot control our tongue. Proverbs chapter 17 verse 28, it says, "Even a fool who keeps his mouth shut, who keeps silent, is considered as wise. When he closes his lips, he is seen as an intelligent person." The third thing of what can ruin our reputation is an untamed, uncontrolled, and undisciplined lifestyle. Apostle Paul, in 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12, he urged each and every one of us, Let no one despise you for your youth, because we are young. But instead, set an example before believers in speech, in conduct, how we live, In speech, how we talk, how we behave. In conduct, how we live. In love, how we love one another. In faith, in our faith before God. And in purity, how we live our life before God. Paul here, he calls each and every one of us. And he encourages us, he urges us to live a lifestyle of discipline. And we have looked at how can we protect our reputation. Ecclesiastes 12 verse 1, he says, Solomon said, "Remember your Creator in the days of your youth." The New Living Translation mentioned, Don't let the excitement and pleasures of life cause you to forget your Creator. Honor Him in your youth before you grow old and say, life is not pleasant anymore, or life is meaningless. We can see three things from here of what can protect our reputation. Number one is a disciplined life. Solomon said, don't let the excitement or the pleasures of your youth cause you to forget God, your Creator. We have to control our desire. We have to kill these desires of the flesh before they kill the desires of the spirit. Second is, keep God at the center of your life. Once we keep God at the center of our life, we will never do things that will hurt God. In turn, it will give us a good reputation, because we will never do any things that will bring shame to God's name. The third one, and the final one, that can protect our reputation is, honor Him in your youth. Honor Him in your youth. Sometimes as young people, we think, okay, living for God is boring, because there's no joy and no peace as the world offers. But this is where we are wrong. David in Psalms chapter 16 verse 11, he says, "In your right hand, at your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. And in your presence, there is fullness of joy." In your presence, there is fullness of joy. See, that Solomon, when he wrote this verse, he had everything that he wanted in life. This is the moral of the story. Solomon, he who have lived his life, the life that we all wanted, covered and surrounded by riches, glory, thousands of servants surrounding him, who will tend to his needs, who will cater to his needs. He have whatever he wants to have, he can have it. Exotic food, whatever he wishes, he can have. Even if he wants to have water on a golden cup, he can have that. He have a king-size bed, he can sleep peacefully at night. But amidst of all these pleasures of life, Solomon, he regret at the end of his life. That is why he urged us, this is the moral of the story, he urged each and every one of us to remember the Creator in the days of your youth. To remember the Creator in the days of your youth. And even Paul, Apostle Paul, he urged us to protect our reputation by writing in Philippians, his letter to the Philippians, chapter 4, verse 8, he says, "Finally, or in conclusion, my brothers and my sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, and whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Do those things." So, in conclusion to this session, I would like to draw some principles that will help each and every one of us, as I used to set a principle, a boundary to my life. In order for us to have a good reputation and a good name, we should do two things. Number one is, set boundaries to our desires. Set a clear boundaries to our desires, our passion and our appetite. When I say appetite, sometimes we think only about food. It doesn't only mean about food. but what we feed our hearts and our souls. What we watch on the screen of the television and on the screen of our mobile phones. That are the things, those are the things that we feed our souls and our mind. And the second one is being mindful on the things about God, on godly things. Reprogramming our thinking by reading the Word of God, by praying, this will shed light to our path. Just as Daniel, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. Knowing that there is a reward for each and every one of us. Just as Daniel, Meshach, Shadrach, Abednego, they set a boundary that they will not eat the food offered by the king, that they might defile. So, as a result, they changed the nation. They have a very, very good reputation that most of us wants to have that name. As in contrast to Judas and Solomon. These are the things, these are the principles I would like to draw in front of each and every one of us to have these. Set boundaries to our desires, our passion, and our appetite. Second one, be mindful on the things of God, on godly things. Thank you so much. So now, let us pray. Our Heavenly Father in heaven, we come before you, we thank you so much for Lord speaking to us, for teaching us from your word, Lord, for challenging us, help us live a godly life, help us Lord live a pure life and a holy life, Lord, that people when they look at us, they will see you, we will reflect your glory wherever we go. Lord, we commit each and every one of us into your mighty hands. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen.